Hello and welcome to Current Issues with me, Tarun. The National Capital Territory of Delhi makes headlines time and again due to the transportation, traffic and pollution woes that Delhi has been facing. If we start from the initial days, court had ordered that CNG should be introduced in buses, in public transport buses in Delhi. Recently also, the courts intervened and ensured that SUVs over 2000cc diesel shouldn't be allowed to be sold in Delhi. As also, Delhi keeps on suffering traffic snarls which actually trouble people a lot. What is the solution to the national capital's transportation and traffic problems? And why have we got ourselves into such a mess? To discuss this issue with us, present in the studio are Ashok Bhattacharji, his advisor CSE and former director Unified Traffic and Transportation on Infrastructure Planning and Engineering Center. R.G. Gupta, town planner and former policy commissioner DDA, would also join us on the debate. I'll first go to R.G. Gupta and ask him, what would be your opening comment? Why has Delhi, the national capital, has become in a state of mess that it has landed itself into now? Yes, R.G. Gupta, can you hear me?
Yes, listening yes. Very well.
Why Delhi has got itself into such a mess?
Delhi has the maximum problems with regard to traffic and transportation. I have noted down 25 points. I take one by one.
Yes.
Suppose this is Delhi, Eastern Expressway, Western Expressway. Western Expressway has been constructed and solving some problems. Eastern Expressway, after completion, some problems will be further solved. Rapid rail projects, we have planned it from Delhi to all the cities like Ghaziabad, Meerut.
Yes.
This is Palwal, then Faridabad, then Gurgaon, then Rohtak. If these all will be connected,
yes,
it will take much less time. Then people will live there in Meerut, they will come to work here. This will also solve some problem of the traffic transportation.
Okay.
The new bypasses also proposed in Delhi to connect ring roads,
various
ring roads. That will also solve some problem. We also want trucks should not enter in Delhi. There should be 6 integrated freight complex.
Will enter Delhi after?
Should not.
That has not happened up till now. It will happen.
Not happen. You construct 6-7 integrated freight complex come wholesale markets. So they will come JT Road.
Okay.
Stop here.
I'm taking this as your opening comment. I'll come back to you.
I'm going
to Ashok Bhattacharji at this moment. Ashok, if you could tell me, why has Delhi landed up in such a mess? What would be your opening comment?
Actually, you see, the problem of Delhi, it has started about 20 years back.
Yes.
Problem has started exactly 20, 25 years back. Because the actual growth of private vehicles over the last 20 years. And what has happened, I'm hearing some more other sound.
Okay.
What has happened that there is a growth of vehicle in a very and there is absolutely no effort from the government to improve the public transport system, particularly bus. In spite of metro station has come, a metro system has come, you find that it is only taking about 10% to 10% of the overall load of traffic. Okay.
Yes.
And buses are also taking double of that. Point is that if this growth, 1400 vehicles are introduced in this city every day.
Yes.
Now, if this continues to grow, about 30% more vehicle will come on the in Delhi in the over the next 5-6 years. Now, question is that the infrastructure development to facilitate more traffic, more car traffic will not help, which we have seen.
Yes.
We have seen that how many flyovers and elevated corridors have been built, no matter how many wide roads and expressways or other things you do, absolutely nothing will happen unless we improve the public transport system, and there has not been much of improvement. Every part of the best practices all over the world, we find that last 20 years they have actually started reinventing mobility. That means the mobility in favor of other than motorized transport, so that we get more space on road for less, I mean, more people move on a road with less number of vehicles. That is the best practice things can happen. What is happening is now, I'll just give you one example that, but lately, about 10 years back, National Urban Transport Policy has given a direction which favors more sustainable mobility in the city. Recently, decongestion of traffic, that committee, high power committee under the MOD minister, they have also come out with something which states that no more flyovers and elevated corridors will be built, priority will not be given. Rather, we should focus more on improving public transport system and the walking and cycling spaces so that we get more road space for movement and the mobility is improved.
Okay, I take your point. This is your opening comment. I am going to R.G. Gupta at this point. R.G. Gupta, can you tell me, the NGT, the National Green Tribunal, has said that public transport in Delhi must be improved. Now, when we speak of Delhi, this is our national capital, the national capital of India. It does not bode well that the national capital itself doesn't have good public transport according to the size of the population. Do you think, we're not talking of some town in some state, it is the national capital of the country. Do you think that it, though there were some landmark projects like the metro, largely buses and all have been ignored?
Metro is very good one.
Yes.
Metro phase 1, phase 2, phase 3, phase 4.
Yes.
You complete all the four phases.
Yes.
The problem is solved a lot.
Then but there is no feeder transport. After you get down from the metro, there is no feeder transport.
No, this is also proposed near the metro, the high density development should be there.
Yes.
Then we are thinking monorails also.
Yes.
We are thinking the other types of ring railway also to start in Delhi.
But I want to ask you one question. You served in the government.
Yes, very much.
Has the executive failed for the courts to intervene? Because the judges, the judiciary says that if the executive fails, the judiciary has to intervene. So, because of the judiciary only CNG was implemented in Delhi. Because of the judiciary only the recent decisions are being taken. Do you think that somewhere at the political and the executive level, this problem of traffic was not taken into consideration and the courts had to step in to solve
biggest
it?
Biggest problem, parking is there.
Yes.
Biggest problems. You say the FAR has been increased in the residential building, all the buildings, but parking problem has not been solved.
Yes.
Then on the footpaths, so much informal commercial comes, so much workshops comes. These all have to be controlled. We are not controlling it. The biggest nuisance is the informal traffic, informal commercial, informal industrial, small industrial, they come.
Yes.
This creates the problems. But if you see the entire plan, you create the integrated freight complexes, you create more ISBTs.
Okay.
So naturally, problem has to be solved, will be solved.
We have got a range of reactions from the people of Delhi on this issue. My team will play it out for you right away.
ये तो बिल्कुल सही कदम है एनजीटी का कि डीजल की जितनी गाड़ियां हैं बंद होनी चाहिए क्योंकि पोल्यूशन बहुत ज़्यादा बढ़ता जा रहा है दिल्ली में बहुत ही ज़्यादा और ये बिल्कुल सही कदम है मेरे हिसाब से तो
बिल्कुल सही बात है पॉल्यूशन पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू से बंद होना ही चाहिए गाड़ियाँ उनका ही मुद्दा सही है और ये होना चाहिए नहीं तो पॉल्यूशन कंट्रोल नहीं हो पाएगी गवर्नमेंट ने अच्छा कदम उठाया ये
10 साल से पुरानी जितनी गाड़ियाँ हैं ठीक है पॉल्यूशन ज़्यादा होता है और वैसे भी जो यूरो नाम्स हैं हम उनको फॉलो नहीं कर रहे सही से अगर ऐसा भी नहीं होगा तो फिर पॉल्यूशन बढ़ता जाएगा इसलिए बहुत ज़रूरी है कि बैन हो
वैसे ये ठीक भी है एक तरह से देखा जाए तो क्योंकि पुराने व्हीकल हमारे पास बहुत ज़्यादा हो गए हैं वो जगह जगह खराब हो रहे हैं तो उनसे पोल्यूशन ज़्यादा बढ़ रहा है क्योंकि वो टाइम टाइम पे अपना पोल्यूशन नहीं करा रहे इस वजह से अभी जैसे केजरीवाल सरकार ने इसको 15 दिन के लिए लागू भी करा है कि पोल्यूशन जो कि 15 दिन में मेंटेन नहीं होगा तो एक अच्छी पहले देखते हैं इसे क्या मिले
रोड पर इतना ज़्यादा पोल्यूशन हो रहा है इतना ट्रैफिक हो रहा है तो बंद ही होनी चाहिए
पोल्यूशन कंट्रोल करने के लिए कुछ और सोचना चाहिए गवर्नमेंट को ये नहीं कि गाड़ियाँ ही बंद कर दी जाएं मेट्रो को ज़्यादा बढ़ावा दिया जाए और कुछ सोचना चाहिए बट ये नहीं कि गाड़ियाँ ही बंद कर दी जाए
पहले गुटखा जब बैन हो रहा था या बैन हुआ था तो उस समय बहुत ही ये क्वेश्चन उठा था कि जो इस रोज़गार में लोग लगे हुए हैं वो कहाँ पे जाएंगे उनके लिए क्या वो होगा तो अल्टरनेटिव्स पैदा होते रहते हैं और इस तरह के डिसीजन लॉन्ग टर्म में काफ़ी यूजफुल होते हैं और मेरे ख्याल से इट्स अ गुड डिसीजन एंड वी शुड एग्री टू दिस
Ashok Bhattacharya, if you could tell me, the court ordered that diesel vehicles more than 2000 cc and more than 10 years old should be off the roads. Now, what would be your first reaction to this decision, A? And second, has the executive failed that the courts have now started stepping in and taking these decisions? On both the questions, what would be your reply?
Yes, I agree with you that almost government has not taken the appropriate kind of action, which should have actually started about 10 years, 15, 20 years back. Point is, now court has intervened, and what we find is with this particular decision of banning a vehicle, a diesel vehicle, more than 10 years, about 17% of the vehicle will be off-road.
Yes.
Because the 17% of the diesel vehicles are more than 10 years old. But I would like to say that further there has to be some more actions to be taken, one on the point of view of pollution and also congestion, that the new registration, to some extent, there has to be, it has to be curbed. To that extent, that because ultimately, whatever problem we have with the present number of vehicles, first thing is the strategy is to reduce that number of vehicles.
Okay.
Now, whether it is any kind of like odd even, or even the vehicle, banning of vehicle and all these things, what we need to have, that now we should have an action plan or the strategy to actually control or reduce number of vehicles.
But so Ashok, new vehicles, Ashok to Bhattacharji, some extent, I want
we can fix
comment.
That maybe 50% here.
See, isn't it good that we
yes.
improve public transportation so much that people themselves opt for public transportation rather than forcibly
yes.
you know, taking decisions that okay, we will not allow. Do you think the government should actually build up capacity
yes.
rather than forcing people? What do you think? What is your lookout?
I agree with you that I agree with you that first there has to be some priorities to be fixed. First priority is to make available public transport system all over Delhi, and to that extent, that what we say is that presently our 5,000 to 6,000 buses are there. It has to be somewhere around 12,000 buses, 12,000 to 15,000 buses.
You have to double.
Up
you
to,
have
say,
to double
2021
capacity.
Would take quite a bit of load on this.
Okay, I'm going to R.G. Gupta.
Yeah,
at this
it has
moment.
To be. Point is,
I'm going to R.G. Gupta, and I'll come back to you. R.G. Gupta, if you could tell me, court has mandated and taken a decision that you have to have 10-year-old diesel vehicles off. Court, again, even courts ruled on CNG. Courts also ruled on two, three other issues related to the transport. So, you see, courts are now intervening. Do you think the executive somewhere failed?
Zero. They are not working at all. You create a high power committee.
Yes.
Consisting the planners of all the departments, maybe DDA, maybe MCD, maybe NDMC, cantonment, everything.
Yes.
Then you prepare the plans. The speed of planning is very, 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 very slow, negligible. You create a high power committee, make the plans, especially the trucks should not enter in the city at all.
Yes.
The buses should come only concerning with the public, not the people are coming. So these things have to be taken care of, control of pollution. You segregate office hours. Why from 10 a.m. it can be 8, 8:30, 9, 9:30, 10.
But are you in favor of a ban?
Bank.
Ban. Ban.
Should be. It should be. That's a very small problem, not a very big problem.
Yes.
But I am saying, please don't increase the density too much in Delhi.
Yes.
Density first one. Number, don't permit the mix of land use. Now people come, they start their informal commercial, then they start their these workshops. Why this is like this? Footpath is meant only meant for the public.
Yes.
All for the cycle tracks. But people are not following it. So I make a high power committee to
yes.
see all the things, to create, to coordinate, integrate, evaluate, monitor all the points.
Okay.
All such points.
Okay.
Then only problem can be solved, otherwise not.
R.G. Gupta, after speaking to R.G., I'm going to Ashok Bhattacharji now. Ashok Bhattacharji, I would like to ask you, all over the world are engineers that who work in the government. They have also visited Bogota in Brazil. They have also visited various countries where BRT has worked successfully. Why do you think there is a big problem in even implementing projects in India? You know, you see a successful example somewhere in some country, but you can't implement it in your country. Do you, where is the bottleneck that, you know, you can't even implement? See, metro, because it's an elevated corridor, happened. But with buses, we are in very, very pitiable condition. I mean, people, I mean, I have spoken, and we have also spoken, we have officers to whom we speak who work in the government. They say that you can't travel with dignity in public transport. You walk in and you walk out, the whole clothes that you wear will get spoiled. So they say, okay, it's better to drive rather than go in public transport, even though it is cheaper and fast. Do you think that should be also be taken care of, that there should be a dignity of an individual who travels in public transport? Otherwise, who will do?
This is very correct.
Exactly. Exactly. The public transport system is not only the number of buses, it is also that how efficient service is, how frequency of the service, accessibility to the public transport system in a more walkable distance. Those will help in, you know, getting people more to the bus transport. One thing is sure, that the occupancy thing, if you say, as of today what we find that in some cases occupancy of the buses are very high, but in some cases we find that occupancy is very low. So it is not properly distributed. So what we need is the efficiency in the bus transit system. You talked about Bogota. Now what in our case BRT failed and the Bogota it is actually working. Now point is, any kind of system like metro also, it started with one corridor and then we have a network. BRT would actually work once the full corridor is developed and the network is built. It was not done. And moreover, if you know that there are a number of agencies, nobody takes ownership. You know, if one department is pursuing something, other agencies are not taking ownership for that, for successful implementation of the policy. Now our problem is that we have beautiful policies. We have number of policies, you know, by the central government, even the state government sometimes.
Multiplicity of agencies and nobody taking ownership. R.G. Gupta wants to come in.
Yes, exactly.
What point do you want to make, R.G. Gupta?
BRT is not successful, will never be successful.
Okay.
Number one. Number two, dignity. I so far have never went to any bus, not metro.
Yes.
But time problem is with me. So these things have to be seen, how to make the bus better so I can sit there, this metro better.
Your average businessman or even an executive or a government officer also will not take the public transport. I mean, that's a big issue.
So far not. So far, so I mean, never taken. Never taken. So these things have to be seen. You see here, the density is too much.
See, parking problem is too much. People in India question when the mayor of London can take a tube to his office.
They can take.
Indian IS officers or never, Indian officers will never take, because never. They themselves know the condition is pitiable.
Never. That is very
correct. So I'll go to R.G. Gupta. I'll go to Ashok Bhattacharji. Ashok Bhattacharji, when you speak of cities like London, so you have the mayor of London taking the tube, government officers there taking the tube. But in India, people and government officers who advocate the common people to use public transport themselves will never be found using one. Don't you think that public transport should be so good that they themselves should travel? I mean, the message will be sent only when you yourself start doing it. If judges abroad, say in the International Court of Justice in Hague, you have judges who use cycles to go to office. This is what a Supreme, even judges from India go there and they have used cycles. But in India, the culture is not there. You see, okay, the common people should use public transport. That is for the common people. But the government officers and the other people will not use. The businessmen will not use. Somebody who's earning well will not use. So do you think that you must first practice before you preach?
Point is that, you see, everything will happen once the people who are not exactly using public transport, if the policymakers, if they don't use public transport will never improve. If they don't, they want to keep on using private transport, they don't want to walk, the streets will not improve.
Yes.
I'll give you an example, that street design guidelines, UTPEC, we had come out about 5-6 years back, more than that, 7 years back. Point is that if streets are made for walkable and the cyclable, people will walk. It is all over the world, it is happening that people are walking. People are using public transport, is a better public transport system.
Yes.
And that will come only when you give priority to that. If you don't give priority, if your budget provision in the transport sector, 80% of that goes for the flyover and roads, you will never put money for the public
transport. That's a good point, Ashok.
You have given example of the London.
Yes.
London, I'll just give one example, that London today, earlier they had a good metro network. Now they have buses, you find every 10, 15, 20 seconds buses. People are using buses because they are as good as metro. So why we can't do it?
Okay.
If we can spend 4,000, 10,000 crore on elevated corridors or so other things, why don't we put? We say that 3 years or 5 years, we will not build anything. We will only put our money for the public transport and the streets will improve. You just see the changes. Even those bureaucrats and the politicians, they will start using.
Okay, I take your point. R.G. Gupta, how would you react to that? Should government officers also, I'll give you an example of an Indian IS officer, a joint secretary level officer who served in Geneva. When he was posted back to India, you could see him using the cycle and to go to his office. When asked by the media, he says, okay, in Geneva, it's commonplace. All senior officers use cycles to go to office. I've realized it's healthier. Do you think that there is a general reluctance in the Indian governance elite, administration elite, to use public transport, and that is why it doesn't improve?
Is it due to density? Is that density is too much, too much? You see any footpath, you see any central bulge, all the ways that people are sitting, they are too much density is there.
Yes.
You see maximum population 140 crore, then 130 crore, then 33 crores.
Yes.
So there's too much variation in the density. So there are so many problems here. Parking. Can somebody imagine that parking is
becoming the solution is, should government officers start using public transport so it will get better, because they will they'll have the first hand information?
I think this is difficult. Seems to be very difficult.
You're admitting it's difficult in
India. Yes, sir. I never sit in any bus or any this metro myself. Though I don't have the time.
No, but you don't have it. But would you advocate it that now the time has come that government officers should also do it?
I don't think so. They will agree to this one.
You are being frank on this one.
So
I'm going to Ashok Bhattacharji. Ashok Bhattacharji, R.G. Gupta, who was with us in the studio, was very frank. He said that even though it happens abroad, it's very difficult in India. I'm happy that he admits it. So do you think that unless this culture changes, Ashok Bhattacharji, do you think that somewhere the debate needs to start, that unless the officer who takes decisions also knows what people go through in public transport, they shouldn't be compelled to give off their cars and travel in metro forcibly when he can afford? What do you think on this?
Yes, with due respect to Mr. Gupta, who is my senior,
yes.
I'll just say that I don't agree with him to that extent, that we cannot keep on continue to have what we had. We cannot just say that what was happening people don't use and they will not use in future. I myself have used e-rickshaws during this odd even day.
Yes.
I mean, it is that something you have to come out, that I want to share with somebody. I want to, problem in Delhi is people don't want to share. Public transport, they don't want to share. Metro, they want to go, but if there is a crowd, they will come out on that. The point is, even in London Metro, you find peak hour, it is almost people are standing, each, almost touching each other. Point is that ultimately, you have to make up your mind that in this city, we cannot keep on continue to increase number of private vehicles. Parking is a problem which cannot be solved by just satisfying the supply of that, by supplying that. We have to go for demand management, whether it's the travel demand management or the parking demand management. These are the issues which have to be accepted, and not only as per policy, it has to be implemented through proper strategies and projects, which is not happening, but soon I think things will start happening because people are realizing how problem it is.
Okay. I'm going to R.G. Gupta at this moment. R.G. Gupta, I want to ask you, now that the courts have started stepping in very actively, the National Green Tribunal or the High Courts, and they have started ruling in on transportation matters, which are actually the executive domain, but since the executive fails, and then the courts are forced to act. But do you think because the court is now stepping in, we will see executive action, because the executive will realize, okay, we failed somewhere, the court has stepped in, but now it's better we preempt and take good decisions so that the courts don't need to step in at all and we will retain our turf, because it's a turf also, na? It's the executive turf. Do you think that there will be change in the executive actions? Will you see progress?
For this, please create a high power committee,
yes,
of all the departments, and give 20 crores for the planning, replanning, development, redevelopment, construction, reconstruction, management, remanagement. So everything. Let us see. So far, the speed of planning is very, very slow.
You mean because there are too many agencies involved in planning?
Speed is very slow.
Speed is very slow.
There should be independent authority for this one. Having all the departments, having all the acts. If you see the Section 6 of DD Act, very powerful one. Section 8 of DD Act, very powerful one. But somebody has to see and start it.
Okay.
Nobody cares for this one. Nobody read the acts.
Okay.
So, changes have to come, will come.
But they will come. Ashok Bhattacharji, Ashok, if you could tell me, after the recent spate of court orders, when they've been ruling on diesel vehicles, when they've been ruling on 10-year-old diesel vehicles,
when they've been ruling on CNG issues. Do you think executive action will happen?
Yes, it should, because ultimately court orders need to be implemented. A point which you have raised very correctly, that why to always take court's decision or court's, you know, directive to act. What we should have a proactive government which should understand the problems comprehensively, and then we should work out as a government that what is better for the city, what, how to improve the quality of life, the mobility and everything. It, you cannot keep on just doing something which we have been doing for the last 20-25 years and and we have failed.
Ashok Bhattacharya,
there is a need for really reinventing mobility.
Ashok Bhattacharya, give me a closing comment with three things that you would like to see at the earliest in executive action in Delhi, and your closing comment in 30 seconds.
As I said very clearly, that next five years, we should not spend anything on increasing the road space and money on that. Second thing is that much of money what we save, we should put for the public transport improvement and the street improvement. Street by street, we need to improve. As Mr. Gupta has stated, the density, I do not think that much, because the density, if it is more, how come that vehicle are also only increasing? Then we have to really work out the way that we should allow people to have a better place to move, you know, and that is the second part. And third part is that all the streets, actually, if you go around that and Delhi, it is a most unorganized way of things are happening. Parking and the street design and improvement.
Okay, I take your point. I take this as your closing comment. I'm running out of time. I'm going to R.G. Gupta. What would be your closing comment for today's debate?
From tomorrow morning,
yes,
I'm going to start to prepare a plan. Okay. And send to A, B, C, everyone. Please do like this, do like this, do like this. And people react to me. This is my general business.
Okay.
I prepare the plan, send to A, B, C, everyone. Starting from the PM Secretariat, okay, UD Ministry, Transport Ministry, DDA, Delhi governments. Well, this thing has to be done, should be done by the planners.
Okay, the planners should do their job is what you're saying.
Yeah.
Thank you so much, Ashok Bhattacharya and R.G. Gupta, for joining us on this crucial debate. The national capital of the country is facing huge traffic jams, and because the executive has delayed in action, the courts now have had to step in and issue direction on, be it the CNG, making CNG compulsory, and also speaking about diesel vehicles.